Now, a group of computer hackers targeted Israel over the weekend. Israel says it's repelled most of the attacks on government websites. Hackers briefly shut down some of the sites to protest Israel's treatment of the Palestinians. Joining us now from Tel Aviv is our Middle East editor, Elliot Gotkin. Elliot, it doesn't seem like the hackers did much damage.
Well, Francine, they billed it as the largest internet battle in the history of mankind, but it turned out to be anything but. But here to discuss exactly how damaging it was or it wasn't, I'm joined by Uri Rivner, who's the co-founder of BioCatch, which deals with invisible biometrics, so it can tell if you're the person moving your mouse in a certain way, which is interesting in itself. But today we're going to talk about the weekend's hacking. I saw one analyst describing it as childish. I mean, was it really nothing to write home about?
I think it's an accurate description. I mean, the target was 100 websites, government websites, e-commerce websites, but I think these websites handled it very well. They were well prepared for the attack, and the sophistication of the attack wasn't that high. I would say that some of the secondary attacks might be a little bit more worrying. Rather than just denial of service attacks that try to...
Which is when they flood the service.
Yeah, flood the service and try to crash the websites. There were some websites that were penetrated too. Now, after people go to these websites, you know, days later, they might have been infected, or they might be infected with some Trojans. That's far more dangerous because then these people that have internet banking accounts or credit cards that they use online, this may be compromised.
So we'll have to wait a few days, weeks, perhaps, to see what the true impact was.
But generally speaking, I would say that that was a very, very minor attack.
And just how does the government and other companies prepare themselves? I mean, what do they do to prevent their servers, for example, being flooded by these distributed denial of service attacks?
I think the key word is scalability and the fact that you know how to handle these sort of attacks. These sort of denial of service attacks have tried to crash websites in the last decades or so in many countries. 2007 was Estonia, 2008 Georgia, and I think by now a lot of the websites, a lot of the government websites at least, have lots of defenses in place, various technical defenses. I think the bottom line is that the attack was something that they anticipated and prepared for.
Now, some people are comparing this with the number of cyber attacks there were during the Gaza conflict late last year, when there were, the government said, in excess of 60 million attempted hacks on Israeli websites. I mean, how prepared is Israel compared with other countries? And is there a danger that, hey, they saw this off? Is there a danger of complacency here?
I would say that the private sector is probably less prepared than the government sector, as well as the critical infrastructure. In Israel, a lot of the critical infrastructure has separate networks, truly segregated. Networks. So in this case, I would say that the country is more prepared than some of the other countries.
Okay, and do you think that this is a taster of things to come? Maybe they're just kind of seeing where the weaknesses are, and then in the future they come back?
I would say that we should expect more of these sort of operations. Countries, generally speaking, should be also aware of industrial espionage. This is something that has been hitting the West, the US and other countries for a while. And I would say that this is probably more dangerous than trying to kind of topple and crash some of the websites. Because if you have some foreign countries actually stealing intellectual property, that has a long-term damage as well.
Okay, well, let's hope that some of Israeli security companies can protect them. Uri Rivner, co-founder of BioCatch, talking to me after a weekend of concerted hack attacks on Israel, which didn't really turn out to be the biggest internet battle the world had ever seen after all. Back to you.